Hey everyone, if you clicked on this link, then you're probably interested in Fedora i3 Spin and how to get started. Well, this video covers exactly that. If you're interested in i3 Spin and how to get started and you don't want to install it just yet, then it's probably interesting for you. If you specifically want to look at Fedora i3 Spin, it's probably also interesting for you. So this is a beginner video, so for more advanced users, I have lots of i3 content on my own YouTube channel. Feel free to check it out, and I will have a link to the playlist at the end of this video. I made this video specifically for the Fedora i3 Spin special interest group. They were looking for content, and I thought, well, I was looking into creating a video about this anyway. Why not create this video specifically for that need and kill two birds with one stone? And what you'll see in this video is me showing you the first steps you can take with a Fedora i3 Spin. And I'll try to explain every step to you so a beginner can understand. And it's a very easy way to get started with Fedora i3 and a tiling window manager. Without further ado, let's dig into the video. And here we have the booted Fedora i3 Spin. And notice the screen here. It says first configuration, so it knows that it's the first time running this desktop. And notice here it says home live user. So when you load this live environment, it will load it into a RAM disk and it will use a live user. So the configuration you create at this moment is not persisted. And the question here being asked is if you want to create a configuration. And the configuration you create is in .config, which is a hidden directory. And then /i3, which is also a directory, and then /config, that is the configuration file itself. So it doesn't really matter because it's a live user, so the changes are not persisted. So just go ahead and hit enter, and then it asks you, well, what is the modifier key? Is it Windows or is it Alt? And Windows they also call super, and I always do Win as a modifier key. But this is my personal preference and yours may vary. But it's important to keep in mind that this is the modifier key. And you can also change it later if you decide to do so. I will touch on that when we look at the configuration file. And if you're a new user, you may be thinking, oh, well, what now? Clicking on a desktop doesn't have any effect. Let's take a moment and try to understand what we see in front of us. You see the one here, and that is the workspace. And the information you see here on the below part of the screen, and that is the output of a command i3 status. So that's basically this information, which is being displayed in this bar here. And the network icon here, if you left click, then you see that it's connected to a wired network. You can also disconnect and set up a VPN. If you right click, you can edit the connection. You can add a new connection here if you want. To do that, choose your connection type from the dropdown and fit in the connection information. I'm already connected to an Ethernet connection, a wired connection, so I'm not going to bother adding a new one. And now you have this screen open, you're probably wondering, well, how do I close it? There's no close icon or something like that. So if you just hit Mod Shift Q, then you will close this window. So remember, you chose the Windows key as the modifier, so I pressed Modifier Shift Q to quit the program or close the window. Next up will be on how to trigger the operating system installation. Hit modifier enter, and that will trigger a terminal. This is the XFCE4 terminal, which is the default for this Fedora i3 Spin. As you can also read from the text, you have to type live inst to trigger the installation. So let's do that. Live inst and press enter. Give it a moment to load. I'm located in the Netherlands, so conveniently it determines that. And as you can see, there's not a whole lot of screen real estate left over. And there's a couple of things to maximize that. And one of the things is to select a different tiling layout. And this is a tiled layout. This is called horizontal. If you hit Alt S, you will jump to a stacked layout. You see the windows stacked upon each other. And you can click to select between them. And press Alt E again, and it will switch back to the tiled layout we had before. And if this is the first time you are using a tiling window manager, then this is probably new for you. You will just have to play around and it takes a little getting used to, but once you get the hang of it, it will start to feel natural. And for now, you can just commence installing Fedora. And we will not cover that in detail in this video because it's a typical Fedora installation process. Now it has finished installing. and you just need to type reboot to reboot the system. Remember to remove the USB stick, and now you see that it has two entries to select from. And it automatically selects the top one. And after some time, you should see the login screen presented to you. You see the current date. And here you can select a session. There are only two here, because it's only i3, but you can select i3 and i3 debug. The current character set is English US. Some accessibility options are here, large text and high contrast. And on the far right, you can suspend, restart or shut down. And let's log in the first time on a freshly installed system. And probably you will recognize this screen. Don't be alarmed, you haven't done anything wrong, but look at the text here. It says home/demo in my case, and that's the user you selected yourself when installing Fedora. Just repeat what you did when you launched the live instance. And at this moment, you basically finished the installation. And now let's start using it. I already showed you that if you hit Mod Enter, you will launch the terminal. And that's launched on workspace 1. If you hold down Mod and press 2 on the keyboard, you will see 2 as a workspace. Now 2 is the current workspace. Workspaces are dynamic, meaning if there are no programs running on a current workspace, it will disappear automatically. And let me show you real quick how it works. If you have multiple, so you see 1, 2 and 3 now. And you can switch by holding Mod and pressing the number of the workspace. And let's move to the next step, and that is Application Launcher, DRUN. Hit Mod D to launch DRUN, and you can search for an application you want to launch by typing. For example, type Firefox, which is installed by default on Fedora. Now hit Enter to launch the selected program. And if you want to send this program to another workspace, hit Mod Shift and then the number of the workspace you want to send the program to. And now the browser is on workspace 2. And probably you will want to install some new software, so let's look at that. One of the key components of using a tiling window manager is that you use the keyboard more and more. So for installing software, we're also going to be using the terminal, which is a common use case in Linux, to be honest. So let's open up a terminal. You can use the DRUN menu or you can use Mod Enter. If you made the user administrator during the installation, you can use sudo straight away. But first, let's do a DNF update. And there are plenty of updates ready for us. It was a significant update and it also had a new kernel, so you need to reboot to activate the new kernel. And you see the new kernel in the list, so 6.1.5. And once we're greeted by the login screen, we can log in again. I'm now becoming root, and let's search for some software to install. I want to install ScreenKey, so DNF search ScreenKey. And you can see the entry is being displayed here. And now you do DNF install -y. And -y is to confirm any questions automatically. Done, and hit Ctrl D to exit the root session. And any newly installed software should be found automatically in the DRUN menu. And ScreenKey is now running. So you can see any key presses I do on the keyboard. And now let's focus on tiling again. You will have one here and hit Mod Enter. So the Windows key is identified as a super key. Let's say you want to create a grid. If you had Mod Enter again, a new window spawns on the right. But you don't want that. So close the terminal again, move the cursor to the left and hit Mod V. And hit Mod Enter and you have the vertical split. And just hit Mod Enter here again and then you can see you have kind of like a grid at this moment. I'm now using the mouse cursor, but you can also use navigate using the keyboard. And for that you use JKL semicolon. Which is not exactly like the Vim navigation, but one key shifted to the right. And you can also use the arrow keys. Just remember you need to hold down the Mod key. And like I said in the beginning, there are various types of tiling. In the RefGuard i3, they like to speak about changing the container layout. There's default, stacked and tabbed. and mod S brings up the stacked layout, and also mod W to do the tabbed layout. Revert back to default by pressing mod E. And you can make the windows move place, so swap the window position, mod shift arrow down or mod shift arrow up. And also move it to the right and of course also to the left. And before we look at the config, let's first install Vim. And you could edit this config in Vim, but you can also use Nano if you prefer. It doesn't really matter. Just use what you're familiar with. So let's go over the config, not the whole config, but just some highlights. So you can see here the mod is bound to mod 4, that is the super key or the Windows key. Mod enter executes the i3 sensible terminal, which is mapped to the XFCE4 terminal, like I showed you. You see the binding for mod shift Q to kill. Killing sounds awful, but it's actually a very common term in the Unix world. So you kill a process, basically. So if you kill a process, means closing or ending its lifespan. You see here mod D that executes the drun menu, as you can see here. Here you see the movement keys being mapped. The split orientation of windows, and also if you hit mod F, you do a full screen toggle, and also the container layout. So if you hit mod shift space, you float toggle, and that could be handy if you have like a control panel that needs to be on top of some other windows. Restart and exit, I will cut to that later. And resize, let me open up a new window, and you hit mod R and you are able to resize it using the arrow keys. And the last piece here, the bar, I showed you that in the beginning with the information that is gathered by the i3 status. So it just leaves two commands, and that is if you change the file at all and you want to effectuate the file, you save the file and then you hit mod shift R to reload. And last, to get out of the session i3, you hit mod shift E and then you have the nag bar showing and then you can end the session. And that's it. And that's it for this video. I hope you liked it and maybe learned something new. Have fun playing around with i3. If we missed anything, leave a comment down below. And see you in the next one. Bye bye.